Fire, a powerful, mesmerizing force of nature. But what exactly is it? How does it form? And what elements are involved in its creation? The answers might surprise you. For a fire to ignite and sustain itself, there must be three essential requirements, known as the fire triangle. These include fuel. Fuel provides the material that undergoes combustion, releasing energy in the form of heat and light. A fuel source can be anything combustible, such as wood, paper, dry vegetation, or fabric. Other fuels include alcohol, hydrogen, petroleum products, for example gasoline, diesel, kerosene, and even certain plastics. Fuel provides the carbon and hydrogen atoms needed for the reaction. Additionally, an oxidizer is necessary to support the chemical reaction that produces flames. While oxygen is commonly the oxidizing agent, alternative compounds can also serve this function. This oxidizer may include oxygen from the surrounding air, as well as substances like chlorine, fluorine, potassium chlorate, hydrogen peroxide, and nitric acid. These substances either provide or act as a source of oxygen, enabling combustion. Chlorine trifluoride is so reactive that it can ignite materials like sand, illustrating the versatility of oxidizing agents in supporting combustion. Finally, heat. Heat is the energy required to raise the temperature of the fuel to its ignition point, initiating the combustion process. Sufficient heat is crucial for raising the fuel's temperature to its ignition point, which is when combustion begins. Otherwise, the fuel will not undergo combustion, and fire cannot occur. The heat breaks down the fuel molecules, releasing energy in the form of heat and light. Once started, the reaction releases additional heat, sustaining the fire. In the case of fire, the oxidation reaction occurs rapidly and is often accompanied by flames. When these three elements come together in the right proportions, they create a chemical chain reaction, combustion occurs, and fire is born. The heat causes the fuel to release gases, which then react with oxygen in a process that releases energy in the form of heat and light, what we recognize as flames. If any of these three essential elements, fuel, heat, or oxygen, is missing, the fire will extinguish. From a scientific perspective, fire is a fascinating phenomenon with various aspects, including its chemistry and physics. Let's now explore the chemistry behind fire. The combustion reactions that occur during a fire involve the breaking and forming of chemical bonds. Witnessing these reactions in action reveals the complex interactions of molecules that take place within the flames. This equation represents the balanced chemical reaction for the combustion process of methane with oxygen. Reactants. These are the substances that participate in the combustion reaction. In this example, the reactants are methane and oxygen. Activation energy. This is the minimum energy required to start the combustion reaction. It can come from an external source like a spark or heat. Combustion products. These are the substances formed as a result of the combustion reaction. Common products include carbon dioxide and water vapor, along with various other gases and particulate matter depending on the composition of the fuel. Energy release, heat and light. Combustion is an exothermic reaction, meaning it releases more energy than it consumes. This energy is released in the form of heat and light, which are characteristic of fire. But after all, there's one question still unanswered. What exactly is fire? Is it a gas, a liquid, a plasma, or is it something completely different? Surprisingly, fire is none of these. In fact, fire is not a substance. It's a process. More precisely, it's a chemical reaction, known as combustion, that releases energy in the form of heat and light. What we see as flames are actually the visible part of this reaction, caused by superheated gases emitting light as they rise. Fire is also a plasma, but only in certain extreme conditions, like in very high temperature flames, which behave differently than what we normally see. Understanding these complex processes requires a deeper dive into the physics and chemistry behind them, topics we'll explore in more detail in an upcoming video, where we'll break down how temperature, fuel composition, and even the environment can change the nature of fire. If you want to know everything about what lies beneath Earth's surface and the layers that compose our planet, check out this video for an in-depth exploration. See you there!